there's a lot of people in Australia now pronouncing that no. I think that's the influence of American television and movies. But I think the way Australians pronounce it is new. New. I always remember on Seinfeld, there was Newman. Jerry would always say Newman, hello Newman, which, well, we would have always said Newman. But anyway, it's new in Australia. Caramel. Actually sure whether we say garage or patio or patio, but I'd probably say garage and patio. No, they're in there, but yeah, I'm not actually 100% sure how I would say them. Cement. Root. The, you know, the bus root. Driving root. Then we pronounce it as in R-O-O-T root. Fillet. Fillet of fish. Myself. Pecan. This is another tricky one that people say either way. If they say schedule, which would be probably how we should pronounce it, but a lot of people might say schedule, but we should say schedule. Hopefully, I think I say schedule. Now, I'm just going to drop into some this one. Is Graham. Graham, the man's name Graham. There's also the Golden Grahams, of course. My favourite breakfast cereal from the USA, Golden Grahams. That was why when I started eating them was because I thought the name Golden Grahams. I didn't realise there was a graham cracker or such a thing, so it seemed like a funny name to have for a cereal. So I tried them and I really liked them, so I kept coming back. There's Stuart. Sometimes we spell like that. Actually, it's probably the more popular spelling, Stuart. And now apparently Megan. That I did read somewhere that only Australians pronounce it Megan. Meghan Markle, of course, famous Megan. Seems to come out more of a Greg, G-R-E-G, Greg. But when I watch the credits or read about it on Wikipedia, it's actually the character's name's Craig. Which, was always interesting, I suppose. And Aaron. Maybe Aaron might be pronounced differently as well in other places. I saw a Jack sort of cartoon actually, and I think it said it was, you know, your apologies to all the errands out there, but it said, you know if you've got lazy parents, if your name's Aaron, because, you know, they've only got to the first page of the baby name book, the first name there. Couple of names and they've gone, oh yeah, that'll do. I haven't really bothered to get past the double A's, obviously, and the baby's name book would be in alphabetical order. But yeah, so I sort of had a chuckle when I read that, but the same sound, isn't it? It's in Melbourne, Brisbane. Different spelling, but the same last syllable. Melbourne, Brisbane. And I'd never thought about that before. Canberra, that's obviously. Melbourne is state capital of Victoria. Brisbane is the state capital of Queensland, and Canberra is our nation's capital. Now, this is actually, this next section, I was actually thinking about doing this as a whole video, but I couldn't really find enough stuff to talk about, so this is actually accent distinguish. I'm not sure if I've got that right actually. Distinguish. Distinguishing feature. Maybe it's features. And it's actually, well, it's actually all to do with the letter R. Actually sort of slip an R in there in the middle and pronounce it drawing. We sort of, like, there's obviously no R in the spelling, but when we pronounce draw, it's draw. And when we add the ing on, we pronounce it as drawing. We slip a little R sound in the middle. And I think they said if they wanted to be the accent, practice it, and if they're not Australian, obviously, then they need to sort of concentrate on the R sound. So draw, and add the ing on the end, and it becomes drawing. And another interesting one with the R, there's the word late. Certainly pronounce the R. So in a way we say later, kind of run it all together, and then suddenly the R is pronounced later, late, later, and at the O in, on, at the end it becomes later on, later on. We pronounce the R. And actually I used to work with this woman, she was in accounts. She had sort of big personality, entertaining person to work with. But when she left every afternoon, she'd always say, "See you later on, see you later," and then, as in, but no, none of our names were Ron, but she'd always say, "See you later on." That was is for drawing straight lines, see? Oh, there we go, I'm drawing. Oh, I've got a double O, I didn't realise that. Then it becomes ruler is the R. Rule, ruler, there's no R pronounced, and then ruler is. Suddenly the R's thrown in there and pronounced, and so rolls it into the is. Sam. South Wales. So in best before date. Labelled on packaging, okay. I might be printed in there somewhere. Don't think I'm going to be able to read that, so yeah. So I saw that, thought that was interesting, and actually that was... I probably should have said that it's at the beginning of the video, but anyway. Got it out of order. So that was the inspiration for this video, was leaving the ketchup and thinking. Differently. And I probably do. And I've got a list of those, some proper names, and then I've been able to tie in this idea that it's interesting. I've only found this out recently, or realised that we did, adding a sort of a sneaky R in there when there's no R. Sneaking R in drawing, suddenly pronouncing the R when there's a vowel followed in words like later, later on, ruler, rule is, and river under. So yeah, well, I thought that was interesting. So.